So I will try to answer to your question about the whether the universe is expected to end or not, and what is the ultimate fate of the universe. So the quick answer is, according to the present cosmological model and according to the most recent cosmological observations, we expect the universe not to end, and in particular we expect it to expand forever, and in particular we expect it to expand faster and faster in the future. Now, in order to give a more accurate answer to these questions, I need to first make two points. I need to explain you what is the difference between the universe and the observable universe, and I also need to explain you something about the standard cosmological model and how the different energy species inside of the universe will affect the expansion of the universe. So, as Einstein told us 100 years ago, information is not propagating at an infinite speed, but rather at a finite speed, which in particular is the speed of light. So, for example, if I let a ball drop here, people observing this event at different distances will see this event at different times. When we try to look at the sky, when you look at things which are very far from us, the information that we will receive is very old. In this sense, given that the age of the universe is finite, the observable size of the universe is finite. So this is of course different from the whole universe, because there are parts which have never been able to come into causal contact with us. And in principle, the whole universe can be infinite. Actually, this is what we think, but it's not really probable. We can now switch to the second main ingredient. So how can we understand the evolution of the universe? And in particular, this is something which again goes back to Einstein, in particular to general relativity. In particular, what general relativity tells us is that matter changes the structure of the geometrical structure of the space-time, meaning that different energy species will drive different modifications of the structure. In particular, as far as we know now, in our universe there are three different species, which are radiation, matter, and dark energy. In particular, we know that both radiation and matter drive an expansion which is decelerated. On the other hand, something like dark energy drives an expansion which is accelerated. In principle, we could also have some contraction, but the most recent observation we have are telling us that we are now switching from a phase of expansion which is decelerated, which is driven mainly by matter, to a phase of expansion which is accelerated, which is driven by dark energy. So as far as we know now, the universe is expanding, and is expanding faster and faster, and this will keep going forever in the future. At this point, we have all the ingredients to give the more detailed answer to your questions. In particular, according to the model we have now, what we know is that the universe is expanding, and in particular is starting to expand faster and faster. As a consequence, at some point, points will recede from one another at a speed which is higher than the speed of light. Actually, this is not in contradiction with the theory of relativity, but this means at some point distant objects won't be able to send information to us. In particular, the light they will send won't be able to reach us in the future. So what will happen is that in practice the observable part of the universe will shrink, it will become smaller and smaller and smaller, until at some point we will only be able to observe only the local structure around us, which are tied very close to us because of the attraction of gravity. So the final answer is the universe most likely is expected to expand forever, at least according to the most recent observational data. So there's no end, and what, if you want, will end is the observable universe as we know it now, because in the future there will be some kind of end of cosmology, because the part that we can observe will become so small that we will only be able to observe things which are very close to us.